सदाशिवसमारंभ शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मनीति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सह नो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विजातिपुरो वेदाग्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशमुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽं। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमा पूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। So we begin with the new pada, the second pada in the third adhyaya, which is sadhana adhyaya. In the first pada we looked at the vairagya pada, vairagya section, where the gati and agati of the jiva has been discussed, whether he goes to naraka or swarga, there will always be punarjanma, पुनरावृत्ति एंड सेम संसरण विच इज दुख रूप कंटिन्यूस। नाउ दी द्वितीय पाद डील्स विद दी तत्यं त्वं पदार्थ शोधन इन दी महावाक्य इन दी सेम साधन पाद साधना अध्याय। सो इन इंट्रोडक्शन भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र सेज इत्थं गत्यागति निरूपणेन कर्मफलेभ्यो विरक्तस्य महावाक्यार्थ ज्ञानाय तत्त्वं पदार्थ अस्मिन् पादे शोध्येते इति हेतु हेतुमद्भाव संगत्या द्वितीय पादः आरभ्यते। दि संगति बिटवीन दि फर्स्ट पाद एंड दि सेकंड पाद ऑफ दि थर्ड अध्याय इज सच एज टू हेतु हेतुमद्भाव संगति। व्हाट इज दिस हेतु हेतुमद्भाव संगति? इत्थम इन दिस मैनर एज इट हैज बीन सीन इन दि फर्स्ट पाद गत्यागति निरूपणेन थ्रू दि एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ गति एंड आगति ऑफ दि जीवा, ट्रैवल ऑफ दि जीवा टू अदर लोका एंड रिटर्न, व्हाट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड देयर, दि जीवा इज गोइंग टू रिटर्न नो मैटर व्हाट, बिकॉज ही इज अनुशयी, ही इज शेष कर्मवान, देयरफॉर इवन आफ्टर स्वर्ग भोग जीवा हैज टू कम बैक हियर फॉर मिश्रण ऑफ सुख एंड दुख। ऑल्दो इन स्वर्ग देर वॉज हार्डली एनी दुख, बट हियर हैविंग रिटर्न देर हैज टू बी भोग ऑफ बोथ सुख एज वेल एज दुख, देर बाय कर्म फला इज नॉट नित्य। स्वर्ग विच इज अटेंड एज कर्म फला इज डेफिनेटली नॉट नित्य, बिकॉज पुनरावृत्ति इज डिस्कस्ड थ्रू द पंचाग्नि विद्या। इन दी पंचम आहुति जला बिकम्स अब बिकम्स जीवा, टेक्स द फॉर्म ऑफ द जीवा, देर बाय कर्म फलेभ्यो विरक्तस्य। दिस पुरुष हु नोज दिस तत्व एज टू कर्म फला कैनॉट गिव मुक्ति बिकॉज इट इज अनित्य, देर बाय ही हैव वैराग्य एंड देन कर्म फलेभ्यः विरक्तस्य। वन हु हैज वैराग्य फ्रॉम कर्म फल, ही इज not thinking of moksha as a possibility through karma, because karma leads to karma phala, karma is nitya, karma phala is nitya, therefore nitya karma phala cannot come from nitya mukti, which mukti which is nitya cannot come from karma, it cannot be karma phala. This is what even Mundaka Upanishad says as to वैराग्य इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ एनालिसिस ऑफ अवर ओन एक्सपीरियंसिस एज टू वेदर दे लेट टू नित्य सुख और अनित्य सुख। परीक्ष लोकान कर्मचितान ब्राह्मणो निर्वेदमाया नास्त्यकृत कृतेन, सेज़ दी मुंडक श्रुति। परीक्ष लोकान अनुभवान, हैविंग एग्जामिन्ड दी एक्सपीरियंसिस, वन्स ओन एक्सपीरियंसिस, And one, if one knows from Shastra or from others' experiences also, one can learn, having examined those, Brahmana Nirvedam Ayat, Brahmano Nirvedam, Nirvedam there means Vairagya, attains Vairagya, would attain Vairagya Ayat, then Parikshilokan Karmachitan, Karmachitan. So, which are these Lokan experiences? They are all Karmachitan, they are Karma, Phala, Karma, Janya, Ityartha. So, Karma Janyan, Lokan, Pariksha, Brahmana, Nirvedam, Vairagya Mayat, he would attain Vairagya. As to what is his Viveka or Jnana which led to Vairagya? This Vairagya is not just by having some one-off Anubhava. It is Manana Siddha, it is Pariksha Siddha. So his analysis has led to it, therefore it is Jnana Janya Vairagya. What kind of Jnana does he have? Viveka Janya Vairagya. Nasti Akrutaha Krutena. Krutena Karmana Akrutaha Mokshaha Nasti. Through karma, which is going to result in karma phala, nasti akruta krutena, krutena karma, through karma which is done, which has a beginning and end in time, through that there is no akrutaha moksha. There is no possibility of moksha which is not a result of karma. This is what he understands, because moksha he knows is nitya sukha as described in the shastra. This is what he has been looking for, and karma has not led to that as per his experiences and what shastra says is karma janya karma chita. Therefore everything that is a resultant of karma being transitory, being anitya, what is nitya and what is not anitya, what is nitya, that moksha is akrutaha, and that cannot be obtained from karma, cannot be a result of kruta karma. Then further it says guru mevabhi gacchit ityadi, he should approach a guru for jnana because he has no adhikara in karma left anymore. So karma phalebhyo viraktasya mahavakyartha jnanaya. For mahavakyartha jnana, he should go to guru. And what will guru do over a period of time? Shaping up the sadhaka through whatever is necessary, giving, imparting knowledge that is needed, finally gives mahavakyartha jnana, mahavakya jnana, and then artha jnana also. Thereby, tattvam padarthau asmin pade shodhyate. Shodhyate. Tatpadartha and Tvampadartha in the Mahavakya Tattvamasi means you, Shvetaketu, or any Jiva who is Shvetaketu Stani, Jiva Stani Shvetaketu. So, any Jiva who has approached a Guru and has heard the Mahavakya Tattvamasi, there Tat means Ishvara Brahma, Parabrahma, whereas Tvam means this Jiva, the listener Jiva of the Mahavakya Tattvamasi. So when he hears Tvam, he knows Tvam Padartha as oneself who is limited, and that limited Jiva is said to be Ishvara with Nama Rupa in the Chandogya, Shruti, Shastodhyaya, there Shvetaketu. And instead of Shvetaketu, this listener replaces himself there. Because when he hears Tvam, he understands it as Aham. And Tat is Brahma, therefore when he hears Tattvamasi, he understands Aham Brahma Asmi. Since he has changed the Madhyama Purusha to Uttama Purusha, the verb also changes in the same manner. So he says Aham Brahmas, he hears Tattvamasi, but he does not repeat that Tattvamasi. It is not a mantra to repeat it for Japa. He understands it as Aham Brahmasmi. So this Aham that he understands after analyzing this Tvam, what is that Tvam? Tvam is Aham, and who is really that tvam pointing to? It is not pointing to this namarupatmaka shvetaketu or namarupatmaka jiva that I am devadatta. I am without this body mind sense complex, without which I cannot be Ishvara. This is how his understanding should be, but initially it is not so. Even Shvetaketu, who was so qualified in all the four Vedas, he had not only Padajnana and Kantastikarana of all the four Vedas, but he had Arthajnana also. He was a Pandita. To that, Shvetaketu, who was Pandita, who was a Dharmika, who was having a backing of Karma and Upasana, as a Brahmachari of course, he had trouble understanding this. How is it possible? Therefore, that Tat and Tvam has to be understood properly through Bhagatyaga Lakshana or Jahadajal Lakshana, thereby Mahavakya Arthajnana. For Shabdabodha to take place, Vakya Arthajnana to take place, Tat and Tvampada Artha, Tadartha and Tvampada, Tatpadartha and Tvampadartha are explained in such a manner that they are literally shodhyate, means purified. But what is the purification there? To land on the meaning that makes sense, lakshana has to be used, because the shakti of the padas gives vachyartha, and that vachyartha equation isn't working in mahavakya. In mahavakya, this alpashaktiman samsari jiva, Alpajna Jiva, cannot be equated to Ishvara, who is Sarvashaktiman, Jagatkarta, Karmaphaladata to all Jivas. Jagatkarta means Srishti Sthiti, Layakarana and Sarvajna Ishvara. So literally you cannot make an equation and say yes, it makes sense. So in which Bhaga is the equation valid, in which Bhaga it is not, for that analysis has to be done. That analysis is this Shodhana here. So Tattvam Padartho Asmin Pade Shodhyate Iti. Therefore, what Vairagya has led to this Mahavakya inquiry, Vairagya becomes the Hetu. Viveka Janya Vairagya becomes the Hetu for the purpose of Mahavakya Arthajnana, without which Moksha is not possible for this Mumukshu. Tattvam Padartha has to be understood, have to be understood both, and then Asi would be easy. Thereby, Vairagya discussed in the, as a result in the first Pada, becomes the Hetu, and this Pada where Tattvam Padartha Shuddhi is done for Mahavakyartha Jnana leading to Moksha becomes a Hetu Mat. Thereby Hetu Hetu तुमत भाव संगत्या द्वितीय पादा आरभ्यते तत्र पूर्वं गत्यागति चिंतया जागृत अवस्था निरूपिता. वेयर इज दिस गति एंड आगति? दिस गति एंड आगति ऑफ दिस जीवा गोइंग टू अनदर लोका एंड कमिंग बैक फ्रॉम दैट लोका, ऑल दैट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड एनालिसिस ऑफ द पंचाग्नि विद्या इत्यादि इन द वेदास इज in the Jagratavastha, and it is discussing the Jagratavastha. It is not that the Jiva is travelling in the Swapnavastha, nor is he travelling in the Shushuptiavastha. So the travel that is discussed is Jagratavastha travel in a different kind of a body, alright, after dropping this Sharira in Marana. Some kind of a body is given which is Jagratavastha, because Swarga Bhoga cannot be Swapna Bhoga, it cannot be In Shushupti there is no bhoga, in there is no Vishaya bhoga. In Swapnavastha the Vishaya bhoga is not continuous in the sense that स्वर्गफला इज लॉन्गर देन दिस जन्म हियर मल्टीपल टाइम्स, सो हाउ कैन इट बी स्वप्न अनुभव, सो इट हैज टू बी वॉट, इट हैज टू बी जागृत अवस्था अनुभव, एंड देयर बाय वॉट वॉज डन अर्लियर, तत्र तत्र मीनिंग इन द अर्लियर पाद तस्मिन् प्रथम पादे पूर्वं गत्यागति चिंतया जागृत अवस्था निरूपित. इनिशियली वॉट इज नीडेड इज यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इन द थ्री अवस्था जागृत अवस्था. Now what is this swapna avastha? Swapna avastha, having known what is swapna avastha, what is the characteristic of the jagrat avastha, what is the swarupa nature of the jagrat avastha, and what is the characteristic or nature of the swapna avastha, with that swarupa chinta, what do you get? The avasthatraya pariksha is also means to understanding this tvampada. It is also useful for tatpada analysis, but in tatpada there are not many doubts because shastra is the only pramana for tatpada. We don't have an iota of knowledge of who is this srishtikarta. If at all there is srishtikarta, if at all it is there, then is it one or many? We have absolutely no way to know. Even with tarka, we will land on something which is not conclusive. So shastra is the only pramana for tatpada. There cannot be any doubt as to what is this tatpada. Whether it is of this type or that type, and whether I am one with that tatpada or not, there can be doubts there. But regarding the tatpada itself, meaning of the tatpada itself, there cannot be doubts. It is comparatively easy because there is no contradictory pramana of a different level. Meaning only shabda pramana can be there, one can do mimamsa if there is a doubt as to what this tatpada means. So in tatpada, shastra is the only pramana and the doubts are answered by shastra itself. Unfortunately, when it comes to tvampada, not only shastra is saying something as to what is the nature of this jiva, but I have my own backlog of anubhava which is contradictory to what shastra is saying, and my anubhava is day in day out. I may or may not study the shastra. Even if I study the shastra, my anubhava will always be stronger. I will consider, unless trained, as to my anubhava and my buddhi which backs this pratyaksha jnana. Jnana, anubhava is pratyaksha jnana there in this context. So that pratyaksha jnana becomes a basis for further anumana, inference, logic buildup. All this is going to be stronger for a layman unless trained as to jiva, that I am, my nature, my characteristic. By that I am limited. There is absolutely no way that I am Ishvara. If at all I study the Shastra and understand the equation, if I do not study any way, I am limited. I am trying to make ends meet, trying to improvise day in day out. But knowing the Shastra, whose Tatparya is to say, you are Brahma, there I find difficulty to understand because Tvam has a different source of understanding which is so dridha, it is so firm across anadi janma that it cannot be shaken at all easily. Even with great difficulty, if I shake it and try to understand, still the purva samskaras are going to attack again and again. Therefore this tvampada has to be spent a lot of time understanding, and holding on to that understanding is not easy. So most prakrana granthas also spend time in tvampada. Asi becomes easy because where is the difficulty in asi? You are that. In that are, the verb, there is no issue. The issue with the verb is with the tvampada. And the tatpada also, the kind of tatpada that is being described by the shastra and the kind of tvampada that I know, there cannot be a C kind of a relation between them, equation. There cannot be an equal to sign. यू कैन नॉट से यू आर दैट बिकॉज आई नो वॉट आई एम एंड शास्त्र इज टेलिंग मी वॉट तत् इज देयर फॉर दिस त्वम बीइंग नोन टू मी एंड तत् बीइंग डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय द शास्त्र दैट काइंड ऑफ तत् दिस त्वम आई कैन नॉट बी अहम कैन नॉट बी दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्शन टू द असीपद The Asipada is easier once you know what is this Tat and Tvam in reality. Therefore, Asi need not be discussed at all once Tat and Tvam are understood. Then in Mukhyartha, there will be equation. Once Shodhana has been done. Otherwise, Lakshana alone can make this equation possible. Therefore, Shodhana has to be done of Tatpada as well as Tvampada. So this Tvampada is this Jiva who is having three avasthas. One of the ways is avastha tare pariksha, and this swapna avastha discussion can lead to two things. One is what is the multiple things. Let's answer only two things here as to what is the nature of Jiva. Is he the same kind of Jiva as Anubhava tells us in Jagrata avastha? Whereby this Tvampada being equated with Tatpada cannot be valid. Is it the same Jiva? Swapna Anubhava tells us that it is not the same Jiva who is Jagrat Jiva. Jagrat Jiva and Swapna Jiva, although they are one in analysis, in Swapna Avastha this Jagrat Jiva and Swapna Jiva consider themselves to be having a different kind of a world. The Swapna Jiva does not, although he considers himself as Jagrat in Swapna, Jagrat Jiva in Swapna, still he has experiences which are different from what he has in waking. People and circumstances and things may be same, but still his experiences are his own experiences. They are not the experiences of the Jagrat Prapancha Gata other Jivas. They are very subjective, they are individualistic. Then this prapancha that he underwent anubhava of in swapna, when he wakes up, he knows that all that was false. So who created such kind of a world? If the jiva can be understood as the source of this prapancha in swapnavastha, then it can lead to the swayam jyotishtva of jiva, meaning this jiva who is the meaning of Tvampada mistaken in the Jagrata Avastha as a samsari jiva and thereby objects to he is being equated to Ishvara and considers it as a glorification arthavada, which is not bhuta arthavada. It is not for the purpose of mentioning a fact. This is what he is objecting to. All that will start loosening up because that is not the Swapna Jiva. The Swapna Jiva is the Swapna Karta. He is the one who is lighting up the entire Swapna Prapancha, including the Sthavara Jangama and the Bhuta Padarthas there, Pancha Mahabhuta Ityadi. All the sentient and insentient beings are lit up by this very Jiva. Therefore, by nature, this Jiva is Prakasha Swarupa, Chaitanya Swarupa. This is the context in which the second pada opens by saying Tadantaram Tvam Padarthasya Swayam Jyotishtva Siddhaye Swapnavastham Nirupayitum Idamaha. The Swapnavastha is being looked into after Jagratavastha in the first pada. Although Jagratavastha was not specifically mentioned, but all that was discussed is in the context of Jagratavastha only. Swapnavastha has not been touched in the first pada. Now this Swapnavastha is being looked into and inquired into for what purpose? Tadarthya Chaturthi Swayam Jyotishtva Siddhe Kasya Tvampada Arthasya Jivasya Tvampadasya Arthaha Ya Jivaha Tasya Swarupaha Swarupatvena Swayam Jyotishtva. By Swarupa, he is Swayam Jyotish Swarupa, he is Chaitanya Swarupa, who does not borrow Chaitanya from anyone. He is Prakasha, his own Prakasha. And for the Siddhi of that, Swapnavastha becomes a very good source of understanding. It is a good example to look into and it becomes a source for understanding one's own swarupa. One can inquire into it, and thereby swapnavastham nirupayitum, to describe the swapnavastha, not for any other reason, only to establish the tvam padartha jiva being swayam jyotishta swarupa, swayam jyotish swarupa, thereby the sandhyadikaranam. Sandhya meaning junction between the two. That is why we do sandhya. Sandhya vandana is what? Sandhya vandana is vandana at the time of sandhya. Sandhya is when the day and the night merge, or the night and the day merge, or the day and the afternoon merge is there. And then of course afternoon and the evening there if we consider madhyanika also. So sandhya is a junction time. The junction is what? The junction between the deep sleep and waking, and vice versa, is where you have this swapna. Not literally so, but this is the meaning that we get, and therefore swapna avastha. The first sutra there, Bhagavan Sutrakara says, sandhye srishti rahahi, sandhye srishti rahahi. This is a Purvapaksha sutra. The first two sutras are Purvapaksha sutras. Purvapakshi is looking into what is this swapna avastha, whereby Siddhanti would want to understand Tvampada as Swayam Jyotish, Tvampada Artha as Swayam Jyotish Swarupa. Before that, just one more point here as to Tattvam Padartha Asmin Pade Shodhyete. Why do you need that Shodhana? What kind of a... we looked at what is the objection Arthata, but an example is given as to what in Tarka we have seen, Tarka Sangraha, when we looked at it, we had seen some kind of examples in the Padakritya Tika there, Vannina Sinchet. So Vannina Sinchet, so see, why does Vakyartha Jnana does not take place? There is some contradiction. If someone says that you are Brahma, you are Ishvara, no Jnana takes place there. Vakya Jnana is what you are, it is not a translation, it is not just an understanding of Shabda. But the Vakya should make sense, then only it is called as a Vakya Bodha, which is called as Shabda Bodha. Vakya, understanding of the Vakya is called as Shabda Bodha. Shabda Bodha won't take place if there is an objection, if there is a question regarding the meaning. So if there is a question regarding the meaning, Anvaya also, if you can make Vyakrana wise Anvaya, if you make Tat Tvamasi, you just say, you know, there is some predication being done there, it is a statement. But then that statement won't make sense. Just like Vannina Sanchet. Vakya, Vakrana wise, has a verb, has some karta, karma, ityadi, karakas. Then the statement can be understood in the sense of the Anvaya. But the Shabda Bodha does not take place. Mimamsaka would say that what is the meaning here? He would ask, what is the meaning by saying Tattvamasi, you are Brahma, what is the meaning there? You have to inquire into what exactly does it mean, because Shabda Bodha is not taking place. Vyakrana Anvaya is possible. Similar to what Vannina Sinchet. Should we, one should shower with, let's say, with what? With fire. Shower with fire or sprinkle with fire. What kind of a sense does it make? It makes no sense. Fire cannot be sprinkled, it cannot be sprayed. So if you say spray with was sprayed or should spray with fire, Anvaya can be made. It is a simple Anvaya. You can translate in any language that you know and make sense out of the words there, but words put together with the verb do not generate any meaningful understanding. Similarly, Tattvamasi, when you hear, there is no meaningful understanding at all, because Tat has a meaning, Tvam has a meaning, and Asi does not go together at all. Just like Vannina Sinchet. Vanni, one word, in Tritiya Karaka, and Sinchet, one verb, they don't go together at all. Individually, they have meaning. Individually, Padartha Jnana is taking place, but Shabda Bodha, because Vakyartha is missing, therefore Shabda Bodha does not take place. We understand the word meaning, but the sentence meaning is not taking place. That is called a Shabda Bodha. That does not take place. Therefore, this Shodhana has to be done. We have to see, oh, when the Mukhyartha is not possible, then Lakshana has to be looked into. So, Ashuddhi Nivarana Meva Shodhana. What is this Shodhana? Ashuddhi Nivarana. Whatever is not making the Shabda Bodha possible, that kind of Padartha should be taken. That itself is Shodhana here. Further, what we are looking at the Sutra now. Is there anything else there? Hetu Hetu Madbhava Samyata. So, Vairagya is Hetu, Tattvamartha, Padartha Shodhana is Hetu Mat. Okay. So, now Sandhye Srishtir Ahahi. Sandhye Srishtihi Ahahi. So, this is the Padacheda. So, Sandhye. Sandhi, as I said, Sandhi is what in this, here the word is Sandhya. Sandhya, and in Saptami Ekvachana you have Sandhye. Sandhye meaning Swapne, as we saw in the Swapnavastha. Srishtihi. Srishti is very well known as to Srishti. Who Srishti is this? Ahahi. Ah. Shruti says what? Indeed, he definitely, Shruti talks about Srishti in Sandhya meaning in Swapna. In Swapna, Shruti talks about Srishti. Therefore, there is Paramatma Srishti in Swapnavastha also. It is not Jiva Srishti, or it is there, you know, is the Prapancha in Swapna existent or not? This is the question there. So, we will see that in the Sangati. That's the Sutra Artha. Padantaratvat avyavhita adhikaranena asya na sangatyapeksha. There is no expectancy of the sutra sangati. The pada sangati. Adhikarana sangati. Sorry. Pada sangati has been mentioned. There is no adhikarana sangati because last adhikarana was in the earlier pada. This first adhikarana is in the next pada. Therefore, there is no adhikarana sangati. Adhikaranena asya sangati na apeksha nasti. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे व्यावहारिक स्वप्नावस्था तो जीवस्य पृथक्करणायोगा स्वयं ज्योतिष्ठा सिद्धि स्वयं ज्योतिष्ठ असिद्धि पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट दिस स्वयं ज्योतिष्ठ दैट यू क्लेम इज नॉट पॉसिबल बाय एनालिसिस ऑफ स्वप्न अवस्था व्हाय बिकॉज व्यावहारिक स्वप्नावस्थातः जीवस्य दिस जीव हु इज प्रेजेंट इन स्वप्न ही इज प्रेजेंट इन स्वप्न Which Swapna? That Swapna which is Vyavaharika, meaning it is Ishwarakrita. Paramatma has created Swapnavastha in which this Jiva finds himself as the dreamer. Therefore, this Jiva who is part of this Swapnavastha created, Swapna Prapancha created by Ishwara, he cannot be separated. He is part of that Swapna Prapancha. Being part of Swapna Prapancha, Jiva, Swapna Jiva cannot be separated from the Swapna Prapancha, and therefore Prithakkarana Ayoga, due to this Jiva as part of Swapna Prapancha cannot be separated from Swapna Prapancha, thereby Swayam Jyotishta Asiddhi, you cannot prove that Jiva is by nature Swayam Jyoti. He is Swayam Jyoti Swarupa, cannot be shown because he cannot be separated from the Swapna Prapancha. Whereas Siddhanti says what? Tadyogat tatsiddhirti phalaveda. Tadyogat meaning prutakkarana yogat. Jiva can be separated from Swapna Prapancha because Swapna Prapancha is created. This Jiva is not created. Jiva is Paramatma by Swarupa, Atma who is Swayam Prakasha. Who is Swayam Prakasha Swarupa. He is lighting up the Swapna Prapancha, and thereby the lit up Swapna Prapancha can be separated from this Jiva. This Jiva can be separated as the illuminator of the lit up prapancha. Therefore, Prithakkarana Yoga, Tad Yoga, Tad Siddhiri Swayam Jyotishta Siddhihi. Swayam Jyotish Swarupa of this Jiva can be established iti Phalabheda. This is the difference between the Puropakshi and the Siddhanti's analysis. Evam hi Swapnam Adhikrutya Shruyate. Purva Pakshi says, टेकिंग दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द स्वप्न व्हाट डज द श्रुति से वी हियर दिस अथ रथान रथ योगान पथ सृजते इति. सो परमात्मा क्रिएट देर आफ्टर हैविंग पुट दिस जीवा टू स्लीप ही क्रिएट्स व्हाट रथ चैरियट्स एंड कनेक्शन विद द चैरियट द पाथ एटसेट्रा ऑल ऑफ दिस ईश्वरा क्रिएट्स परमात्मा क्रिएट्स इति श्रूयते. दिस इज व्हाट वी हियर इन दि श्रुति. Therefore, it is व्यावहारिक सृष्टि इन स्वप्न. तत्र किं स्वप्न सृष्टि ही व्यावहारिकी उत माया मात्रमिति संदेहे. Just let me close the window. Some children yelling. So tatra kim swapna srishti vyavahariki uta maya matramiti sandehe. Whether this srishti in swapna, swapna prapancha has been created by Ishvara the way it is there in the jagrata avastha. Is there a similar kind of a srishti or same srishti continues there? Therefore it is vyavahariki uta maya matram, or is it just, you know, magically appearing? Different from the way it is appearing or very logically put together by Ishvara and presented to the jivas the way jivas prarabdha is due. In that manner the jagrat prapancha has been created. In similar manner is this swapnavastha, swapna prapancha in swapnavastha created. Uta maya matram means it is different from the vyavaharika srishti in jagrat avastha, and this is something magical that is taking place. Maya Shakti, Avidya Shakti, due to the Avidya Shakti of the Jiva, it appears. So there is no reality to it, it just appears. Reality meaning the worldly reality, empirical reality is not there to the Swapnavastha, and thereby it is Maya Matram. Iti Sandhe. When such doubt arises, Purva Paksha Sandhe Jagra Sushuptyoho Sandhav Bhave Swapna Swapne. So Sandhe means what? It is a Taddhita. संदौ भवः संध्या और संध्यम इन न्यूट्रल आल्सो तस्मिन् स्वप्ने. इन दैट स्वप्न विच इज देयर इन द संधि बिटवीन द संधि ऑफ व्हाट बिटवीन संधि ऑफ जागृत एंड सुषुप्ति अवस्था वेकिंग एंड द डीप स्लीप स्टेट बिटवीन देम व्हाट टेक्स प्लेस इज अ स्वप्न दैट संधि इज कॉल्ड अ संधि इज द मीनिंग वर्ड यूज फॉर स्वप्न. स्वप्ने सृष्टि ही व्यावहारिकी एव पूर्व पक्ष इट इज व्यावहारिकी. It is just like this empirical reality. He, why? Yasmat. He means yasmat. Why? Because atharatha nityadika shruti reva maha. Because shruti says in that manner. It says that Paramatma creates these rathas and all those which are in the swapna avastha. Kincha, moreover, Purvapakshi gives another sutra. Nirmataram chaike putradayascha. Nirmataram chaike putradayascha. Further what? Swapne putradayascha kamyante. Putradayaha are the kama vishayas kamyante iti hetoho tatra eke shakinaha. Eke means some shakis, some veda shakis. Say what? Nirmataram amananti. They say that some shakhas. Shakinaha amananti meaning some shakas say, Veda shakas say that there is this creator. Why? Because putradeshcha kamayante. Kama vishayas, they are desired and then there is this kind of a creation. That's what it means really. In the sapna, the nirmataram, the creator. Sucha means kincha, moreover, what eke shakinaha, some of these followers of particular shakas, they say that they also consider him, Paramatma as what? Nirmataram, consider him to be. So, eke and putradeha are not in samanadikarnim, because what is the padachya? Nirmataram cha, eke, putradeha cha. So, there are two chas there. This putradeha and AK should not be put together. AK is also in plural. So एके शाखिनः those who belong to particular shakas, some of these followers of mean or followers of some of these shakas, they say what? They say Paramatma is Nirmatara. Amananti Nirmatara Amay. They consider Paramatma as Nirmata of this Swapna Srishti. Putradayascha, that putradayascha is separate. What is that putrad? Putradayascha kamayante, kamyante, putradayascha kamyante, yatra yasmin swapne. In that swapna, we'll see, in the shruti we'll see. Kamyante, putradayascha kamyante, in that swapna, there are vishayas desired, and that those desired vishayas are given by Paramatma in the swapna. Therefore, Paramatma, they consider, A.K. Shakina, they consider Paramatma as Nirmatara, Nirmata, Nirmatru. So in Dvitiya Ekvachana, it will become Nirmataram. We'll see more in the Vritti, it will be clearer. A.K. Shakina, Jeeva Vattatha, Asminneva Swapne, Kamanam Nirmataram, Ishwaram Amananti. So A.K. Shakina, those who belong to particular Veda Shakas, they say what? Jeeva Vat, just like Jeeva, Tatha Asminneva Swapne. In that very swapna, kamanam nirmataram, Ishwaram amananti. They consider Ishwara is the one who is creator of the vishayas in the swapna avastha. So who is this Ishwara? He is like Jiva. You think that the Jiva is the creator, they say Jivavat, just like some consider Jiva, Ishwara also, some other consider Ishwara, Ishwara is the creator, like this Jiva is the creator, you say, some Shakis say that Ishwara is the creator of this Swapna. This is what some Shaki, some who belong to, people who belong to some Shakas, they say. And what is that they say, what is the exact phrase? Exact Shruti, ye esha suptesh jagrati kamam kamam purusho nirmimanah iti. So they say, yaha esha suptesh jagrati. So this one who is suptesh jagrati, one who is awake among these sleepers. So that yaha esha kamam kamam purusha, yaha purusha, so kamam kamam nirmimanaha, that person is what? Nirmata. Jiva is sleeping, jiva goes to sleep, and among the jivas, supteshu, so the jivas who are sleeping, this person, this purusha, not person, this purusha is Paramatma, who is the waker there, who is awake. While the jiva sleeps, while all the jivas or their prana is the meaning there really, yaha esha supteshu praneshu, you can take for the simplicity, you can say this jiva is sleeping, prana is also sleeping. Actually prana is, we saw elsewhere, prana was established as one who wakes in, who is awake in Sushupti. All the Indriyas and Antakrana Ityadi Buddhi goes to sleep, but this in deep sleep in Sushupti Avastha, Prana is the one who is ticking. He is non-corrupt. We saw that he couldn't be corrupted, therefore he is praised. But you have to look at it from the drishti of the deep sleeper. From the perspective of the deep sleeper, Prana is non-existent. So you can say Supteshu Praneshu also. Or you can take as a simpler meaning for now, in the context, as the jivas are sleeping, so who is the one who is creating the swapnavastha? When this jiva has gone from jagratavastha, he is sleeping to the waking world, at least not in deep sleep, you can say sleeping to the waking world, then who is creating a world there in swapnavastha? Yaha jagrati, yaha esha supteshu madhyeshu, supteshu madhye yaha jagrati, saha purusha nirmimanaha. Kim nirmimanaha kamam kamam, whatever is desired by this jiva who has gone to sleep, whatever is desired, this Ishwara Purusha हू इज अवेक वाइल द जीवर्स आर स्लीपिंग, ही कीप्स ऑन क्रिएटिंग निर्मिमाण, ही कंटिन्यूज टू बी अवेक एंड कीप्स ऑन क्रिएटिंग द डिजायर्ड ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर द जीवा, मल्टीपल ऑब्जेक्ट्स इति पुत्रादयश्च. एंड व्हाट पुत्रादयश्च, व्हाट इज पुत्रादयश्च, सन्स एटसेट्रा, चिल्ड्रन एटसेट्रा, तत्र काम अभिधीयन्ते काम्यन्ते इति. सो पुत्रादयश्च तत्र अभिधीयन्ते काम, विच आर दिस कामम काम निर्मिमाणः, व्हाट आर दिस कामास, पुत्रादयश्च कामाः, दैट्स हाउ द अन्वय कैन हैज टू बी मेड, पुत्रादयश्च कामाः, कामानां निर्मातारं च एके, परमात्मा कामानां निर्मातारं च एके शाकिनः आमनंती, एंड देन यू कैन से पुत्रादयश्च तत्र कामाः, दैट्स हाउ द सूत्रार्थ कैन बी मेड यूजिंग दिस श्रुति. दिस इज व्हाट द पूर्व पक्षी सिंह, तत्र काम अभिधीयन्ते, व्हाट आर दिस कामास विच आर स्टेटेड, काम्यन्ते, दिस कामास विच आर डिजायर्ड आर ऑल चिल्ड्रन एटसेट्रा, वॉट एवर दी जीवास वॉन्ट, तत्त जीव वॉन्ट्स तत्त काम, एंड दोज आर इंक्लूडेड बाय पुत्रादि शब्द इन प्लूरल. एवं च स्वप्न सृष्टि व्यावहारिकी, देयर फॉर वॉट इन दिस मैनर स्वप्न सृष्टि इज क्रिएटेड बाय परमात्मा, जस्ट लाइक जागृत सृष्टि, जागृत जागृत प्रपंच, स्वप्न प्रपंच इज ऑल्सो व्यावहारिक प्रपंच, एंड द सृष्टि इज व्यावहारिक सृष्टि, जस्ट लाइक जागृत अवस्था सृष्टि ईश्वर कर्तृकत्वात्. व्हाट इज द हेतु, ही सेइंग एवं च स्वप्न सृष्टि व्यावहारिकी ईश्वर कर्तृत्वात् क्षित्यादिवत् इति अनुमानेन सूत्रेण सूचितम्. सो दिस सूत्र यूज बाय द पूर्वपक्षी, पूर्वपक्षी सेज थ्रू द सूत्र एन अनुमान, ही इंडिकेट्स एन अनुमान दैट इज बीन यूज. व्हाट इज द अनुमान, स्वप्न सृष्टि व्यावहारिकी, स्वप्न सृष्टि इज एम्पेरिकल क्रिएशन, वाय ईश्वर कर्तृकत्वात्, बिकॉज ईश्वर इज द क्रिएटर ऑफ सच स्वप्न सृष्टि ऑल्सो, क्षित्यादिवत स्वप्न प्रपंच ऑल्सो, वाय हाउ क्षित्यादिवत, एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन लाइक दिस अंकुर इत्यादि, ऑल दिस क्रॉप्स हैव बीन क्रिएटेड आदिपति, ऑल दैट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड इन जागृत अवस्था, ऑल दैट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड बाई ईश्वर, देर फोर दैट जागृत सृष्टि इज वॉट, इट इज व्यावहारिकी. सिमिलरली स्वप्न सृष्टि इज ऑल्सो व्यावहारिकी, वाय ईश्वर कर्तृकत्वात्, बिकॉज ईश्वर हैज क्रिएटेड एज पर दि श्रुति पुरुष ईश्वर निर्मिमाण जागृति, सो ही इज द वन हु इज अवेक एंड ही क्रिएट्स ऑल दीज काम्य वस्तु पुत्रादि, देर फोर क्षित्यादिवत ईश्वर कर्तृकत्वात् स्वप्न सृष्टि ऑल्सो इज व्यावहारिकी इति अनुमान सूत्रेण सूचितम्. तस्मात् पूर्व उदाहृत श्रुत्या एतदनुमानेन च स्वप्न सृष्टि व्यावहारिकी सिद्धम्. देयरफॉर पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज टू व्हाट, ड्यू टू दिस हेतु अनुमान एंड श्रुति हैज बीन कोटेड थ्रू द श्रुति आई हैव मेड एन अनुमान, एंड देयर बाय पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट पूर्व उदाहृत श्रुत्या एतद अनुमानेन च, यूजिंग बोथ स्वप्न सृष्टि हैज टू बी व्यावहारिकी, इट कैनॉट लेट यू स्प्लिट दी व्यावहारिक जीव इन स्वप्न from the vyavaharika prapancha that is seen in swapna, cannot be split. This jiva who is vyavaharika jiva, srishta jiva in swapnavastha cannot be separated from the swapnavastha prapancha which is also srishta prapancha. So vyavaharika jiva cannot be separated from the vyavaharika prapancha, and thereby Swayam Jyotishta Siddhi is not possible. Swayam Jyotishta Asiddhi, that is what his conclusion is through Vyavahariki Swapna Srishti. We look at Evam Purvapakshe Siddhanta. So Evam Purvapakshe Sati, Prapte Sati, Siddhanta, when this Purvapaksha across these two sutras had been established from the perspective of the Purvapakshi, which seems valid, then the Siddhanti gives the Uttara in the next sutra. We'll see in the next part. आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे. नमस्ते, धन्यवादः.
धन्यवादः.